Well, if you've been watching our coverage over the past week, you know that we've been on the ground in Tacloban and elsewhere trying to be as accurate as possible. Accuracy is what we care most about here at CNN, and giving information that might actually help people on the ground and help the relief effort in some way become more efficient. In our reporting, it seems, though, here in the Philippines, has become something of a political issue at times. A broadcaster, a radio broadcaster named Korina Sanchez, has apparently taken issue with some of my reporting. She also is not just a radio broadcaster. She happens to be the wife of the Interior Minister who's overseeing the relief effort on the ground. Ms. Sanchez seems to be under the mistaken impression that I said I saw no presence of the Philippine government on the ground in Tacloban. I never said that. Obviously, I have been on the ground in Tacloban for days, and I've in fact interviewed a very heroic Philippine Navy captain, Captain Santiago, who's going out and helping people. I've seen the work that's being done and the work that isn't being done, perhaps even as importantly. Ms. Sanchez is welcome to go there, and I would urge her to go there. I don't know if she has, but her husband's the Interior Minister. I'm sure she could arrange a flight. Here's the broadcast that I think she thinks I said something that I didn't say, and here's what I actually said. As for who exactly is in charge of the Philippine side of this operation, that is not really clear. I mean, I'm just surprised that I haven't. I expected on this day five. I thought I had maybe gotten here very late. That things would be well in hand. It does not seem like that. People are desperate. People do not have any place to, for shelter. It is very difficult for people to get food. Neighbors are helping out neighbors. Water is in short supply. It is a very, very bad situation here.
Let's remember, I showed you a clinic several days ago that was at the airport that the doctors there said they didn't have enough food, they didn't have enough water for the hundreds of people they were seeing every single day, that they didn't have enough medical supplies. That's a clinic at the airport. If any clinic in the entire disaster zone should be able to receive aid quickly and easily, it's the clinic at the airport, and they were not getting it. I don't know what the situation is there today. I certainly pray to God that it is a better situation than it was even 2 days ago. The president of the Philippines has also counseled foreign journalists that they should be accurate in their reports, and we certainly appreciate that counsel. Accuracy is what we strive for. I read in the paper today, it's the first time I've been able to read the news, the president also said in a speech that the media should use our role to uplift the spirits of the Filipino people, to find stories of resilience, of hope, of faith, and show the world how strong the Filipino people are. I would actually say that all week long, in every report we have done, we have shown how strong the Filipino people are. The Filipino people, the people of Tacloban and Samar and Cebu and all these places where so many have died, they are strong not just to have survived this storm, but they are strong to have survived the aftermath of this storm. They have survived for a week now, often with very little food, with very little water, with very little medical attention. Can you imagine the strength it takes to be living in a shack, to be living, sleeping on the streets next to the body of your dead children? Can you imagine that strength? I can't. And I've seen that strength day in and day out here in the Philippines. And we honor them with every broadcast that we do.